Your teacher today is Dr. Bosa Science. Phone 256-778-633-682. Website digitalteachers.co.ug. Here you find notes, exams, marking guides for physics, chemistry, biology, math, and primary science. YouTube channel, Digital Teachers Uganda. Here you find videos for physics, chemistry, and biology. The best secondary school is the Science Foundation College, plus 256-753-80-2709. The best primary school is Lock of Ages Primary School, plus 256-772-849-1061. An efficient physiological homeostatic mechanism is one which A. allows large fluctuations, B. responds to deficiency faster than excess, C. responds to small fluctuations, D. allows positive feedback. You can pause and answer. The answer is C. responds to small fluctuations. Number two, which of the following pairs of hormones, when released, increase the level of blood sugar in the body? A. Secretin and insulin. B. Adrenaline and glucagon. C. Insulin and antidiuretic hormone. D. Secretin. You can pause and answer. The answer is B. Adrenaline and glucagon. Three. Which of the following is not involved in a physiological homeostatic process? A. Positive feedback. B. Receptor. C. Effector. D. Control mechanism. You can pause and answer. The answer is A. Number four. Which of the following is not homeostatically regulated in the body? A. Glucose. B. Water. C. Carbon dioxide. D. Fats. You can pause and answer. The answer is D. Number five. Which of the following is not a requirement for working of a physiological homeostatic mechanism? A. Receptor. B. Skin capillaries. C. Control mechanism. E. Effector. You can pause and answer. The answer is B. Number six. Isolates of Langerhans in the pancreas secrete hormone for regulating A. carbon dioxide. B. blood proteins. C. blood sugar. D. insulin. You can pause and answer. The answer is C. It produces insulin and glucagon to regulate blood sugars. Number seven, A. What's made by a negative feedback in homeostasis? A negative feedback is a control system that reverses deviations from a set norm. Give two characteristics of an efficient homeostatic system. It must have a receptor, a control mechanism, effector, and a set norm. Number 8A, outline the general features of a physiological homeostatic mechanisms. So you have a receptor, capable of detecting changes and the deviation. Two, should have a control mechanism that initiate collective mechanism. Three, should have an effector that call out collective mechanism. B, what are the qualities of an efficient homeostatic system? It should be able to respond quickly to small fluctuations from set point. The figure shows the average blood glucose level in three major blood vessels of a liver in an individual who had a meal at 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. Use the information to answer the following question is, one, compare the levels of glucose in hepatic artery and hepatic vein. The question requires that we give similarities and differences in the levels of glucose in hepatic artery and hepatic veins. Similarities in both blood glucose level increase gradually after a meal. In both, blood glucose levels reach a maximum within 2 hours after a meal. In both, blood glucose level decrease gradually after 2 hours after a meal. In both, blood glucose level never drop to zero. Between 10 a.m. and 12 noon, blood glucose levels in each remain almost constant. Differences. Hepatic vein has higher glucose level than hepatic artery. Compare the level of glucose in hepatic artery and hepatic portal vein. The question requires that we give similarities and differences. Similarities in both, blood glucose levels increase gradually after a meal, reaching a maximum within 2 hours of having a meal. In both, glucose levels remain fairly constant between 10 a.m. and 12 noon. Three, in both, glucose levels decrease after 2 hours of having a meal. Differences. In hepatic artery, glucose level are higher initially. In hepatic portal vein, glucose levels is low initially. In hepatic artery, blood glucose level increases slowly after a meal. In hepatic portal vein, blood glucose increases rapidly after a meal. In hepatic artery, blood glucose level reach a lower maximum after each meal. In hepatic portal vein, blood glucose level reaches a higher maximum after each meal. In hepatic artery, blood glucose level fall gradually after 2 hours of having a meal. In hepatic portal vein, blood glucose level falls rapidly after 2 hours of having a meal. In hepatic artery, between 10 a.m. and 1 p.m., glucose level is higher. In hepatic portal vein, between 10 a.m. and 1 p.m., glucose level is lower. Explain the differences in the level of glucose in hepatic artery and hepatic vein. The blood glucose level in hepatic artery is lower because glucose has been used as blood passes through many organs to reach the liver. So from the liver, it goes to the heart, it goes to the lung, then it comes back to the liver to supply oxygen. So as blood passes through all those organs, glucose is being used. Blood glucose in a hepatic vein is high because glucose is not yet used by the body. It is just leaving the liver. Explain the differences in the level of glucose in hepatic artery and hepatic portal vein. After the meal, blood glucose level in hepatic portal vein is very high due to absorption from intestines. 2 hours after the meal, glucose level in hepatic portal vein fall rapidly because absorption is complete. Between 10 a.m. and 12 noon, blood glucose level in hepatic artery is higher because it is maintained by homeostatic mechanisms and not absorption as in a hepatic portal vein. Thank you so much for listening to this video. Find related videos on YouTube channel Digital Teachers Uganda. Where there is search on YouTube, type in Digital Teachers Uganda and enter. You will be given related videos. Website digitalteachers.co.ug. Here you will find notes, tests, marking guides of physics, biology, math. I'm begging to subscribe to promote my videos. Subscription is free. The best secondary school is the Science Foundation College, +256 753 80 2709. The best primary school is the Rock of Ages Primary School, +256 772 84 910 6.